Today's entry question is, what is the difference between a feeder and a distributor? The significance of asking this question is whether you have visited any substation or not. In the previous lecture, we see the distribution system, primary distribution and secondary distribution. Now we'll see the classification of distribution system. The distribution system is classified in 6 ways. Number 1, according to the voltage, whether it's a primary distribution or secondary distribution. Number 2, according to current, DC current or AC current. Number 3, according to the service, domestic or industrial. And in the case of industrial, bulk consumer or medium power consumers. Number 4, according to the connection, overhead line or underground cables. Number 5, according to the wires, 2-wire system, 3-wire system or 4-wire system. Number 6, according to the connection, ring main system, radial system, interconnected system. What is meant by distribution system? The part of power system which distributes electric power for local use is known as distribution system. There are 4 terms frequently used in distribution system. Number 1, buses. The network nodes being referred as buses. Number 2, feeders. It is a line which supplies a point of distribution network without being tapped at any intermediate point, or it may be defined as the lines carrying power from the secondary substation to the distribution substation. Number 3, distributor. It is a line from which tappings are taken along its length to provide supply to various consumers. Here 11 kV is stepped down to 415 or 230 for domestic and commercial and industrial use. Number 4, service mains. A service main is generally a small cable which connects the distributor to the consumer terminals. Feeders are classified as overhead feeder, number 2, underground cable. High voltage transmission is carried out by overhead system. Due to its low cost, though this system has more chances of power failure due to lightning, storms, etc. The maintenance cost of the overhead system is high. This system is mostly used in rural areas. Number 2, underground cables. This system is more safe, good looking, free from interruption of service on account of thunderstorms and lightning. This system is more expensive and fault location is very difficult. This system is adapted in cities. Here a 250 transformer is installed on a 2-pole structure. Here this is the incoming TNEB line, 11 kV, 11,000 volts. This is the air brake switch. This is a horn gap fuse unit. And this is a transformer primary. This is a transformer secondary. Here the neutral of the transformer is earth. All the metal parts are earth. The lightning arrestor is also earth. There are 3 earth pits. Here the 11 kV line is incoming 11 kV. This is the disc insulator. This is fed to the input of the air brake switch. The output of the air brake switch is put it into the horn gap fuse unit input. The output of the horn gap HG fuse unit is come to the primary winding of the transformer. The secondary winding is goes to the control board. Now we'll see the control board. This is a single line diagram of an electrical network of an engineering college. The output of the transformer secondary goes to the input of the circuit breaker. The output of the circuit breaker is connected to the distributor or bus bars, from where we can tap the power. Here there are 7 feeders. Feeder 1 goes to the administrative block. Feeder 2 goes to the electrical block. Feeder 3 goes to the mechanical block. Feeder 4 goes to the civil block. Feeder 5 goes to the auditorium and sports ground. Feeder 6 goes to the street lighting. Feeder 7 goes to the spare. Now we will see the control board structure. This is a view of a main distribution control board. Here this is a TNEB supply. This is a diesel generator set supply. In event of power failure or maintenance, we have to operate the DG set. We have 7 feeders. Naturally, we need 7 switches. Therefore, totally we need 14 switches. Suppose we switch off the system. You energize the system, that is DG. This is a bus bar. DG is a bus bar. This is a TNEB bus bar. Here, this is a switch. Either I can operate the TNEB supply, I have to switch on. Suppose I want to operate some part of the loading TNEB supply and some part in the DG set. What I have to do? These switches are interlinked. That is a very interesting thing. I can't operate the switch cells at the same time. For suppose I want to operate the switch 4, I must switch off the switch 4, then only I can switch on, such a way that it has been designed. So from the switch output goes to the civil engineering block. Now we will see how distribution takes place in the civil engineering block. This is the main distribution control board. Switch 4 goes to civil engineering block. The civil engineering block is 1+2, ground floor, first floor, second floor. From the switch 4, I am connecting to the MDB, that is main distribution board, through a underground cable. The main distribution board is placed in the ground floor. Here the main distribution board acts as a distributor. In the main distribution board, I have a circuit breaker and panel board voltmeter and ammeter, and these are all the master control switches, S1 for ground floor, S2 for first floor, S3 for second floor. Now from the main distribution board, I am feeding power to the sub distribution boards, that is STB1, STB2 and STB3. All the STBs are connected through MCBs, miniature circuit breakers. That fault will not be reflected in the first floor or the second floor. Power will be available in the first floor as well as second floor. If any fault occur here, the total power will not be available here. Suppose I want to switch off the ground floor for maintenance work, simply I can switch off S1. The power will not be available. Power will be available in the first floor and the second floor. Here the main distribution board acts as a distributor, these all act as a feeders. This is the basic difference between a distributor and a feeder. My humble request is, please visit the substation, learn the components and go through the, learn the single line diagram. Definitely you will learn more. With this I conclude my lecture. Thanks for listening.